This is Luca Comai for BIS 101 with the Biochemistry of CRISPR Part 1. In this video, you will learn the biochemistry of the CRISPR gene editing system. CRISPR stands for Clustered Regularly Interspaced Short Palindrome Repeats, a name derived from the original and natural arrangement of CRISPR systems in bacteria. From the point of view of genome editing, the CRISPR system consists of the Cas endonuclease, here we use a version called Cas9, the guide RNA, and the target DNA. These come together as shown in the equation, Cas9 plus guide RNA equal a double-stranded DNA cut in a target of choice. Last and briefly, you will learn the outcome of a double-stranded DNA cut. This is a three-video series. In the second video, you will learn how different types of DNA repair result in useful outcomes. In the third video, we discuss specialized modification of Cas9 and their uses. Let's start. Cas9, guide RNA, and target DNA form a complex shown here in a 3D ribbon model. A space-filling model is a bit easier to interpret, but what is what? Let's start with the Cas9 protein, shown here as a yellow blob. The features on the blob are domains, that is, parts of the protein dedicated to a specific task. This is the guide RNA binding region. This is the first nuclease domain called HNH. This is the PAM binding region, which is involved in DNA recognition. And finally, this is the second nuclease domain called RAV-C. The detailed names come from the history of the domain. They are easy to forget, but do not worry about it. In summary, the Cas9 protein has four functions. It binds guide RNA, it binds DNA, and it has two different ways of cutting DNA. Next, the guide RNA. The guide RNA has two functions, to bind Cas9 and to recognize the target site in DNA. The natural guide RNA is made of two separate RNAs. After one of the two RNAs is processed, the two bases pair together through complementary regions. Here is the mature guide RNA. The highlighted single-stranded region is homologous to the DNA target. The guide RNA is ready to bind Cas9. For use in biotechnology, a modified guide RNA is used. A linker loop is added to convert the two pieces into a single RNA strand. The advantage of this modification is that a single RNA molecule is sufficient, and this is the form used for genome editing. Here is the result, the guide RNA with a highlighted target homology region. You can even design and order your own. Now see if you can calculate how many copies there are in 2 nanomoles. I bet it is pretty cheap by the molecule. If guide RNA and Cas9 are expressed in the same cell, for example, as transgenes, or if they are mixed in a test tube, RNA and protein assemble to form a ribonucleoprotein complex. The ribonucleoprotein complex is now active. It binds double-stranded DNA and scans it to find a PAM site. I'm sorry to tell you that Cas9 has no eyes. It uses its PAM binding site to recognize the sequence 5' NGG, where N is any base, and binds it. When bound to the PAM, the ribonucleoprotein complex checks to see if the adjacent DNA sequence matches the guide RNA. It does so by base pairing the guide RNA to the candidate DNA strand. If the base pairing match is perfect or very close, the site is recognized. As a result, the target DNA forms a displacement loop. This consists of a single-stranded bubble in the double-stranded DNA where one of the DNA strands is base paired to the invading RNA. Recapitulating, recognition of the target site is a two-step process. A, the Cas protein binds the PAM site. B, the guide RNA forms perfect or near perfect base pairing with the DNA. Note that the RNA recognized sequence alone is not sufficient for recognition by the complex. The PAM site must be present. As a result of the binding process, each DNA strand is exposed to a nuclease. Two single-stranded cuts are made three bases away from the PAM site. You can see the cuts clearly as we zoom in. This is a more realistic view of the Cas9 and the cut DNAs. The ribonucleoprotein complex will eventually fall off the cut sites. The single-stranded DNA reanneal, and we are left with a double-stranded DNA cut, which is compared here to the original DNA. The bend in the DNA signals where the original recognition site was. What next? There are three possible outcomes. If unrepaired, severe genome damage results and frequently the cell dies. Second, imprecise, non-homologous repair leading to the indel mutation. Third, precise homologous repair, which depending on the repair template can introduce new sequences. The next video, CRISPR Biochemistry Part 2, explained these outcomes in detail. Thank you for listening.